Hey everyone, Tankenstein here. In this video, I'll be going over the Export Order event. This is a crafting event for War Thunder that will be running from September 23rd to October 4th, both at 12 o'clock GMT. So this is a crafting event, fairly controversial, if you want to say that, in the War Thunder community because they involve a ton of grinding in a relatively protracted period of time. So you will be playing this game a lot if you want to get the top rewards, and I'll be going over pretty much everything here. Bear in mind, tomorrow I will be releasing a tips and tricks video in regards to how to best complete the expert order event, as it were. So that being said, I'll kind of go over everything again in this, including the rewards, how to participate, the inventory, crafting, so on and so forth. So that being said, let's get into it because there's a lot to go over. And bear in mind, and this is very, very important, Gaijin does have a video. Actually, I'll be linking it in the description below. Excellent video on how exactly the export order event works. So bear in mind, that is an excellent video and does in four and a half minutes what I could do if I were to make an entire crafting guide video in like 15 minutes. So they did a really good job in that. I'll link that below. But anyways, let's get into the overview of this event, and I'll start with what it is. So crafting events are basically events that every 10 minutes of game time of over 50% activity, 50% or higher activity with tier 3 or higher vehicles, doesn't matter if it's air, ground, or naval, basically you can get the various crafting rewards, and that comes in the form of materials and technical documents. And so for materials and technical documents, again, every 10 minutes in battle with a 50% higher or higher activity rating and with rank 3 and above vehicles. So that's very important. So you can get into a match and you could be using a rank 3 vehicle, but if you die and then you get into a rank 2 vehicle, now all of a sudden any time with that rank 2 vehicle does not count. So bear that in mind. And also with naval, a lot of people might think, oh well, you know, this is an easy way to get a lot of activity, but activity with naval is sometimes lacking and oftentimes you'll fall below that 50% ranking. But again, I'll be going over all of that in just a moment. So with the rewards, there are 4 rewards, and there are 2 top level rewards and 2 lower-ish level rewards. So for the top level rewards, we have the PT-16 and the T-14 mod. This is a rank 6 event vehicle, so this is not a premium vehicle. Bear that in mind. Neither is the F-5A, which is a rank 7 vehicle. So the PT-16 T-14 is basically a funny-ish Leopard 2. And again, it's an event vehicle, and this will cost 375,000 crowns, which basically means you have to get through crafting the entire event basically 3 times in order to get this. This is a unique Leopard 2 though, because it is a prototype and it has a 4-second reload. So it is insanely powerful and should feature the DM33 ammunition, the APFSDS ammunition. Now, on the other hand, we have the F5A, which is a rank 7 vehicle, and this is a US tech tree vehicle. Again, not a premium. The PT-16 is a German tech tree vehicle, if it wasn't obvious enough. And the F5A will be something that, again, you need to get through that entire tech tree or the entire crafting tree 3 times in order to get this. So, and I'll go over this in the tips and tricks video, and kind of, it's like a mini guide tips and tricks video, but basically you have to keep your 375,000 crowns. So if you decide to buy the Panzerbill M40 for 125,000 crowns, now all of a sudden you have to make that up again. So really, in total, if you want to get the F5A and or the PT-16 and the Panzerbill, for example, that's 500,000 crowns altogether that you're going to need. But that being said, let's get into the Panzerbill M40. And this is something, actually, I'm seeing more people excited about this than I am seeing for the F5A and the PT-16. And I think the reason being is because we already have tons of Leopards in game, Leopard 2s. And to be quite honest with you guys, I think a lot of people are pretty upset seeing the PT-16 T-14 coming to War Thunder in this event, because it is going to be basically another Leopard 2 PL, where the Leopard 2 PL is actually the most modern Leopard in game as of right now. I believe it was introduced into service just only a few years ago, like 3 years ago. And it's the most modern of the Leopard twos in game, and yet its BR has decreased because you have a lot of people who are wallet warriors who purchased it, got into it, lost a lot of matches. It looks like the Leopard 2PL is bad, and now it has a lower BR because of it. Much the same way the PT16 is probably going to suffer because a lot of people who have no idea what they're doing at top tier are going to buy this as like their first tank, and they're going to do terribly. So my advice to you, if you are a new player and you're looking to buy either the PT16, T14, or the F5A, really use them in test drive. Do not just get these on a whim. They are very, very difficult vehicles to master. And even if you've been playing it for 50 matches, you will have a tough time because you have nothing else in your lineup that you can play with. So just bear that in mind. These are really, really difficult vehicles to master. Not because they're really necessarily tough vehicles to play, but because everyone fighting you will be a lot better than you are. But that said, let's get into the other vehicles. So we have the Panzer Bill M40, and I feel like this one's actually kind of funny because this is the lowest level vehicle. You can probably get this by playing casually throughout the event, and it's the vehicle I see a lot of people being excited about. So the Panzer Bill M40 is a premium Swedish tank, and this is unlike the two top level rewards, this and the HMS Mohawk are both premiums, and they're coupons. So you can buy all of these on the marketplace, and this one will actually help your grind. So the M40 is a light and nimble armored car equipped with a 20 millimeter autocannon, which will be great for capping points. The only problem is this is a rank one, so it's not going to be useful during events or really anything else, but it is a cool addition to the game and something that actually Sweden is missing. They don't really have much variability in their low level vehicles or versatility as well, and this really is a great vehicle. So if I don't actually earn it, I'm definitely going to be buying it because it's a really, really cool vehicle. Now, secondly, we also have the HMS Mohawk, a rank 2 premium. If I'm not mistaken, this Mohawk has has slightly more cannons over top of the regular tribal class destroyers in game for the British, but this is a naval reward. It costs 250,000 crowns, pretty substantial for a rank 2 item. So, I mean, really, I don't know why they didn't give a somewhat unique vehicle. There are some vehicles out there that have only been built once, some ships. They're not all necessarily in classes, or they're in a class of their own. I personally feel that in an event, you should have that, but for whatever reason, Gaijin opted away from that. So that being said, let's get into how to participate. And basically, again, you're just going to need to play random matches, and this could be either arcade, realistic, or sim. And you have to have, for every 10 minutes, you can get either materials or technical documents, and you have to have, in those 10 minutes of game time and match time, 50% activity or higher. Now, materials contain, these are basically chests, and for each one that you earn, they each have one of four different or five different types of materials within them, and you can get up to two or four materials. So for example, you can probably get like two pieces of glass, you know, or four, you know, bricks or whatever the materials might be. So that is more or less kind of how that functions. Or you can get like one glass, one wood, or one brick, one kerosene, whatever the case may be. It kind of, that's where your building blocks are going to come from, unless of course you purchase them on the marketplace. Secondly, the technical documents, these are also very important. They're earned at the same time as the materials, and these are basically standalone documents. You merge them together to get a technical manual, and technical manuals are needed in order to actually get farther, in order to actually make your export model, your export order. Now, there is a small chance that a technical manual, so a fully formed technical manual, which is normally created by combining a bunch of technical documents together, there is a small chance that you could earn a technical manual at the end of a match. So you hope that you get it. If you don't, it's not really bone crushing, but you can certainly get it. And finally, you have your checks. These ones are not necessary at all. They're just there to speed up your export order build time. Normally, if I'm not mistaken, it goes from 12 hours to 4 hours to 1 hour. So 12 hours is without a check, 4 hours is with a regular check, and 1 hour is with a large bundle of checks. So if you get a ton of checks and you get those by getting in first place on your team, then that means that you will be able to get that large bundle. And if for whatever reason you really want to get your export order completed really quickly, that's the way to do it. Probably from day 4 onwards, you'll be able to get checks on the marketplace for between 2 and 5, maybe 6 GJN, depending on the type of check and when you get it. Now, again, I would strongly recommend that you look at that Gaijin video, the one linked below. It is extremely good, extremely informative, and extremely concise on how exactly the crafting event works. But basically, you're going to need to gather materials, and you're going to have a bunch of different stages in which to build the items that you need. And then at the end, you kind of combine those with technical manuals, and you get your export order. Again, you do have the option of using checks to speed it up, but that's totally optional. So once you get your export order, you can sell it, and then you'll get 125,000 crowns. So if after you sell your first export order, you can immediately get the Panzer build. But if you'd like, and I would strongly suggest it, if you're going for the PT-16 or the F5A, you have to sell three of them without buying anything else, and then you'll be able to get those higher tier rewards. So it's very important that you show patience and you get all three of those export orders sold to get 375,000 crowns if that's what you want. So you can also buy the F5A and the PT-16 on the marketplace. If I'm not mistaken, you will be able to actually purchase them with crowns as well from pretty much the start of the event until October 18th. Bear in mind that the event will officially conclude on October 4th, but basically, typically what they're going to do and what they almost always do is they have a few weeks afterwards where you can still trade materials on the marketplace, use up any leftover materials, and then you can kind of build your vehicles after the event ends. And that's what's going on here. Bear in mind, though, that the Panzer Bill and the HMS Mohawk can only be purchased from the 11th of October to the 18th of October. I'm not really sure why that is. That's for PC players, for PlayStation and Xbox. They can do it from the 4th of October, so basically from the end of the event until the 18th of October, whereas PC players can do it from 1 week after the event on the 11th to the 18th. So if you want those two vehicles, for whatever reason, Gaijin has made it so you only have about a week window for PC players or 2 weeks for console players to actually purchase this. So it's really, really weird. If you want your Panzer build, you're going to have to wait. Not really sure why they did it. Maybe they want a lot of people to get the F5A and the PT-16 before, you know, spending lesser amounts of crowns on the Panzer build and the HMS Mohawk. That's my feeling. They want people to participate a lot more and just keep going and going. So it's a little bit of a weird choice, but I think that's so that they can retain more people and retain more excitement for the event for a longer period of time, rather than just having people get the Panzerbill M40 initially and then just quit. So more or less, it's just kind of a way, in my opinion, for Gaijin to get a lot of people to keep playing the game and not just quit when they get their first reward. So that said, while PC players can buy their items on the marketplace in addition to grinding them, PlayStation and Xbox players do not have that luxury. Rather, Gaijin has set it up where you can use Golden Eagles to either buy materials that have 42 items in them or engineer toolkits, which will allow you to receive additional technical documents in battles without restrictions. So you get 6 items for every 10 minutes of battles. So it's really, you can use any rank of vehicle, it seems, and you'll get 6 times the amount of technical documents per match with that. So it's really, really, really cool. Again, you can get these in air, ground arcade, realistic, and sim battles, in air arcade and realistic, and also naval arcade and realistic. So my apologies if I said air sim before. You can get them in air arcade and realistic, and ground arcade, realistic, and sim. So it's just sim for ground. And one really important thing to note here is that you can only get up to 40 material carts and technical documents on a daily basis, with up to 400 material carts throughout the entire event and 320 technical documents, again, over the entire event. And this is from the start of the event on the 23rd of September until the end of it on the 4th of October. And if I'm not mistaken, you have 11 days to get all of that done, but really you only have 10 days of full material cart earning. So if that makes any sense. So once you hit that 400, even if you have some time left at the end of the event, you will not be able to get more materials. But realistically speaking, you only need a few hundred of the material carts in order to actually get one or both of the top tier rewards. So once you hit past a certain point, probably after around 300 material carts, you're really only going to be selling them on the marketplace. And the same goes for technical documents. Once you get past a certain point, you'll probably learn it fairly soon. It's just very difficult to tell exactly how many materials will be needed for each part of the event, just because Gaijin kind of changes it each time. But typically there's around seven or eight different levels with three different, I guess you could say, columns. So it's around 28 things, and each or 24 various things that you have to build before you can actually get an export order. And for each of those, you probably have around four or five different materials that you need at minimum to actually get that done. So let's just say 5 times 24, we're going to have ourselves a total of 96 total items that you're going to need in order to actually progress. I'm sure it's going to be a little bit more than that, but that's more or less about how much you're going to need. So just bear that in mind. There will be a lot of grinding, and outside of the Panzerbill, maybe the Mohawk, you're going to need to do a bit more than just casual grinding to get all of these. But that all being said, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. This is a much, much longer video than I had kind of expected to make, but I feel like it is a useful video, and I hope that you guys get some use out of it. Either way, thanks so much for watching. You know the dealio, like, comment, subscribe. But, I hope you guys enjoyed it and learned from it. That all said, thanks again, and I hope you all have a great day. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you all on the other side.